Welcome to HealthWise. In this video, you will learn some tips and ways to protect yourself, family and loved ones from the new viral coronavirus, COVID-19. Sit, relax, get comfy, and be informed instead of being scared. Information is power. Smiles. Back to the topic. How to protect yourself from COVID-19. Follow these simple precautions to reduce your chances of contracting the new coronavirus, which causes the disease known as COVID-19. Since the December outbreak in Wuhan, China, the new coronavirus has spread rapidly, with more than 118,000 confirmed cases in 114 countries as of early March. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, the virus that causes the disease known as COVID-19 seems to be spreading in the community in certain affected geographic areas. As with any virus, however, there are simple steps you can take to protect yourself. Know the signs. The symptoms of infection for the new coronavirus are often similar to those of other respiratory virus infections, such as influenza. Symptoms can include fever, cough, or shortness of breath. Most people will only have mild symptoms, but some can become very sick. When person-to-person spread has occurred with other novel coronaviruses that caused diseases such as Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, MERS, it is thought to have happened mainly via respiratory droplets produced when an infected person coughs or sneezes, similar to how influenza and other respiratory pathogens spread. Spread of MERS and SARS has generally occurred between people in close contact. The means of transmission is similar, through respiratory droplets produced when a person coughs or sneezes, or by direct physical contact with an infected person, such as shaking hands, says Dr. David Goldberg, internist and infectious disease specialist at New York Presbyterian Medical Group Westchester and an assistant professor of medicine at Columbia University Vigelos College of Physicians and Surgeons. If you think you may have been exposed to a person with COVID-19 and have symptoms, before going to a doctor's office or emergency room, call ahead and tell them about your symptoms and any recent travel. You can also utilize a virtual care platform, such as New York City Presbyterian's NYP On Demand, to meet with a healthcare professional by video conference. Depending on the severity of your symptoms, your doctor will determine whether or not you need to come in to be evaluated. Avoid contact with others and wear a face mask if you need to leave your home when you are sick. Keep things clean. Preventative measures are your first line of defense. The best way to protect yourself from COVID-19 is to practice good hygiene and to make these CDC recommendations part of your routine. Wash your hands often with soap and water for at least 20 seconds, especially after going to the bathroom, before eating, and after blowing your nose, coughing, or sneezing. If soap and water are not readily available, use an alcohol-based hand sanitizer with at least 60% alcohol. Always wash hands with soap and water if hands are visibly dirty. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth with unwashed hands. Avoid close contact with people who are sick. Stay home when you are sick. Cover your cough or sneeze with a tissue, then throw the tissue in the trash and wash your hands. If you don't have a tissue, cough or sneeze into your elbow, rather than into your hands. Clean and disinfect frequently touched objects and surfaces. Visit the CDC for guidelines on how to properly wash your hands and use hand sanitizer. Yes, there's plenty of science behind this basic habit. What about face masks? You may have noticed a growing number of people out and about with their faces covered, but the CDC does not currently recommend the use of face masks among the general public. As noted above, face masks should be used by people who show COVID-19 symptoms to help prevent the spread of the disease to others. The use of face masks is also crucial for health workers and people who are taking care of someone in close settings, at home or in a healthcare facility. Plan your travel accordingly. The CDC recommends avoiding all non-essential travel to mainland China, Iran, South Korea, and Italy. Older adults and those with chronic medical conditions should consider postponing non-essential travel to Japan. For people at risk for the complications of COVID-19, such as those with underlying medical conditions or those who are older, it may be prudent to avoid any long-distance travel, says Dr. Goldberg. Keep in mind, layovers at airports in these destinations also count. If a layover is unavoidable, the CDC recommends that travelers not leave the airport. Travelers with layovers may still be subject to screening and monitoring when entering the United States. Learned something new? Sure. Don't forget to hit the like, subscribe and also turn on the notification icon to get update on our next upload. Stay safe out there. Additional resources. If you have concerns regarding COVID-19, please call New York Presbyterian's hotline at 646-697-4000. This hotline is available as a public service to provide information only and not diagnose, treat, or render a medical opinion. If you are not feeling well, consider using New York Presbyterian's virtual urgent care for non-life-threatening symptoms such as fever, cough, upset stomach, or nausea. Learn more by visiting nyp.org/urgentcare. For more information, COVID-19 hotline call 646-697-4000. Want to have all latest update on the COVID-19, and also how to protect and keep you and your loved ones safe? Click first link in the description. Be one step ahead the public and learn all tips to be safe from this global pandemic. Stay safe and remember that there is no need to be afraid, just follow the required health safety procedures and tips and call COVID-19 hotline 646-697-4000 for information on COVID-19.